In a joint press conference this evening, the Indian Air Force, the Indian Army and the Navy said that Pakistan Air Force attempted to attack Indian Army's military compounds and that it deployed F-16 to attack India's military installation. Presenting a part of missiles as evidence, the Indian Army said Pakistan has used F-16 to attack India in east of Rajouri. The part of missile called Amram, shown by the officers, is solely used by F-16. The officer added that after India's airstrike in Pakistan's Balakot, Pakistan has resorted to unprovoked ceasefire violations along the LOC, as at least 35 incidents have been reported. The press conference came hours after Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan said that as a gesture of peace, Pakistan will release IAF Wing Commander Abhinandan Vardhman. The officers, however, said that they see this gesture by Pakistan in consonance with Geneva Conventions.
The Indian Navy is deployed in a high state of readiness and remains poised in all three dimensions, on surface, undersea and in air, to deter, prevent and defeat any misadventure by Pakistan in the maritime domain.
Responding to questions on India's strike in Pakistan's Balakot, Air Vice Marshal R.G.K. Kapoor has said that it was premature to say the number of casualties in the terror camp, but India has achieved the intended result.
There is fairly credible evidence with us which proves that there was damage to the camps. The weapons hit the intended target and they caused the damage that was intended. However, it will be premature to say that what is the number of casualties we have been able to inflict on those camps and what is the number of deaths.
A day after Wing Commander Abhinandan Vardhman of the Indian Air Force was taken into Pakistan's custody after a MiG-21 Bison crashed in Pakistan's soil, his father, retired Air Marshal Simhakuti Vardhman, prayed for his son's safe return home and expressed hope that he doesn't get tortured. Upon the confirmation of his release by Pakistan, Abhinandan's father has left for Delhi to receive him tomorrow. Former Karnataka Chief Minister B.S. Yedurappa's comment that India's airstrike in Pakistan's Balakot will help BJP win 22 seats in the upcoming elections became a major embarrassment for the BJP. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan's party, PTI, used the BJP leader's comment to taunt Indians and alleged that Indians were manipulated into warmongering by people who are desperate to win an election.
Pakistan ke takka paatavanna kalisuvanta kelasa enide 40 ವರ್ಷಗಳ ನಂತರ ಪ್ರಧಾನಿ ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿ ಅವರು ಧೈರ್ಯದಿಂದ ಏನು 42 ಜನ ನಮ್ಮ ಯೋಧ ಸೈನಿಕರು ಹುತಾತ್ಮರಾದರು ಒಂದೊಂದು ತೊಟ್ಟು ರಕ್ತಕ್ಕೂ ನಾನು ಸೇಡು ತೀರಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಪ್ರಧಾನಿ ಹೇಳಿದರು ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಇಡೀ ದೇಶದ ಜನ ಇದನ್ನು ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಸರ್ವ ಪಕ್ಷಗಳು ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಯುವಕರು ಕುಣಿದು ಸಂಭ್ರಮಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲದರ ಪರಿಣಾಮ ನಾಳೆ 22ಕ್ಕೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಸೀಟ್ ಗೆಲ್ಲೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಮಗೆ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ.
ಯಡಿಯೂರಪ್ಪ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಡ್ರೂ ಮೇಜರ್ ಫ್ಲಾಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಲೀಡರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ವಿ ಕೆ ಸಿಂಗ್. ಇನ್ ಅ ಬಿಟ್ ಟು ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್, ಯಡಿಯೂರಪ್ಪ ಲೇಟರ್ ಸೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಟ್. Less than 24 hours after an Indian Air Force pilot was captured by Pakistan, Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed a gathering of BJP's booth level workers and said India will fight, live, work and win as one. Addressing more than 1 crore party workers, volunteers and supporters in what has been touted to be the world's largest video conference, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that it is necessary to ensure that nothing is done to dent the morale of our security forces.
Duniya hamare collective will ko dekh rahi hai. Hamari senaon ke samarth par hame bharosa hai. और इसलिए बहुत आवश्यक है कि कुछ भी ऐसा न हो जिससे उनके मनोबल पर आंच आए. इंडिया विल लिव एज वन, इंडिया विल वर्क एज वन, इंडिया विल ग्रोथ एज वन, इंडिया विल फाइट एज वन, इंडिया विल विन एज वन.
However, PM Modi's address came under fire from opposition as Congress accused Prime Minister Narendra Modi of having misplaced priorities and that he was only desperate for a re-election. For more news updates, log on to thequint.com.